One of the things I find about subject matters from musicals is that things that sound like really good ideas from musicals probably aren't, and things that sound like terrible ideas probably are. And I think that has to do with the audience's expectation. The job of the author in any field, is to stay ahead of the audience. The minute they can predict what's going to happen, then you can't surprise them, and then you lose them. In 1985, the Titanic was discovered by Ballard. At the bottom of the sea in the fall of 1985. And I immediately thought, you know, we're coming to the end of the century. I mean, you start thinking about these things, and you start thinking about, you know, the 20th century kind of began around 1911, 1912. It began with the Rite of Spring and Schoenberg and Expressionism and modern, and Picasso and modern art. We're coming to the end of it now. And there's a lesson. There's a lesson unconditional faith in the infallibility of technology. And it's an extraordinary story known by everybody. It's a story about hubris, and it's a story about class structure. And as I was thinking about this as maybe the primary myth of the 20th century, I mean, you know, our ethics went down in the 20th century during the Holocaust, certainly. As I was thinking about that, I thought there's a theme here. And there's a great theme, because as much as the Titanic was a disaster, it was also a great dream. It's what we do. We try to cure polio. We try to make a ship that won't sink. We go to the moon. It has to do with our reach and then our hubris. And as I was thinking about it as an interesting theater piece of some kind, ultimately it got to be 1986, just a few months away, and the space shuttle blew up. And I thought, right, 1-0 ring. So we haven't learned, and we'll never learn, and this is important. And I began to think of it as a show. And after Peter Stone and I got together and fixed Grand Hotel, I said, you know, I've been writing Titanic. And he said, I want to write that too. And that's how we got it. And it became about dreams. And it was a thrill to write, because the secret there was, in the same way that Peter Stone convinced you in 1776 that no matter what you knew, they will not sign that Declaration of Independence. The last thing you think they're going to do. We need to convince the audience, even though they know the Titanic sank, here's what they didn't know, that the people on stage didn't know it was going to have an accident. And so we opened the show with a man kissing his girlfriend goodbye and saying, I'll see you in 2 weeks. And we suddenly realize there's a secret that the audience knows that the stage doesn't know, which is my favorite thing in the theater. Because then we don't know how it's going to play itself out, and we don't know who's going to live and who's going to die. And ultimately, it becomes the story of groups of three. It becomes the story of the architect, who's really the father of the ship. The ship is his dream, right? A dream of speed and sleekness, a poem of technology, something that will... A ship that is its own lifeboat, or so they thought. And also about greed, that's the owner. And also about ultimate responsibility, that's the captain. And those three were played off against three people who could tell you why the ship sank. There's the stoker who knew it was going too fast, the telegraph man who knew that they couldn't get a ship to help them in time, and the lookout who knew that there weren't any, that you couldn't see anything because it was too dark, and somebody had forgotten to put binoculars in the crow's nest, so you couldn't see very far. And those groups of three became three Irish girls who were going to America. And ultimately, I began to see that what I was writing in the Titanic was something about the rigidity of the class system of the Edwardian age, something I had learned at Cambridge while going to school in England. And as a result of that, it's a very popular show in the UK. It's been done 50 times by amateur operatic societies all over the UK. And it was a glorious experience to write. Hell of a preview, but I never lost faith.